from the windy city of Chicago. Baseball from beautiful Wrigley Field. Should be a good one here this afternoon between the Chicago White Sox and the Chicago Cubs. Interleague Baseball next.
And now, your 2021 Chicago Cubs.
And that'll bring up the shortstop, Tim Anderson. He will lead this one off today. The 2-2. Maybe a threat of a thunderstorm or two later on. Game time temperature here in even 90 degrees. Pitch popped up. Number 18 shading to his right. One down. Up next for Chicago, Cesar Hernandez, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
Very difficult to be a switch hitter in baseball today. Without question, the more comfortable side being from the right side. So he's going to have his work cut out for him here, hitting left-handed.
And it's fouled away. Just getting things underway here at Wrigley. Now a ball hit in the air, but in play perhaps down the line. And it's a foul ball. High and deep to center field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Ready now for the White Sox, Jose Abreu. Bouncer to the left side. Throw in time and the side is retired. In now is Nico Hoerner. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Fouled off. Lynn steps into his windup. Here's the 1-2. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Slow roller out to short. Anderson scoops it up. And a good throw gets him one gone. The next Cub up, number 62. He'll get his first shot with the bat here. The 1-1 home. Down the first baseline. And he'll take it onto the bag himself. Two gone now here in the first. So in now for Chicago, Matt Duffy. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. Now here's a swing and a high pop-up drifting into shallow right field. Hernandez is there and the side is retired. Second inning set to go, and that'll bring up the former top prospect as a minor leaguer, Yoan Moncada. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
So that's two pitches in a row above the belt. As a hitter, that's what you're looking for, especially when it's a day game and the ball is carried. That just wasn't a good enough pitch to hit.
So he sets him down swinging. Yoan Moncada goes down to become the first out here in the second inning. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul.
He got the fastball where he wanted and just pulled off of it.
Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. So now here is Gavin Sheets. Will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. And now a good slider that doesn't quite catch the zone. It's 2-1 now. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Here now the 2-2. Swung on but fouled off to the left. Another try at 2-2. Struck him out, so he makes quick work of him here. Three straight strikeouts, and the side is retired. So here's the cleanup hitter, Patrick Wisdom. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. And he fouls this one off. The 1-2. Is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. And stepping in, batting number big. 18. The He's ready for hit. His first AB number here 18. In this one. A ball and two strikes now.
Yeah, I get it. They want to run this guy's pitch count up, but that was a pretty good pitch to hit. He might be kicking himself that he didn't swing at that one.
The 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
That pitch was way down on 2-2, but give the hitter some credit there. Sometimes with two strikes, you're more off to expand the strike zone, but he didn't and held off on that one that wasn't even close.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Number 18 goes down for the second out in the bottom half. 2-2 to the Cubs catcher.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That could be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
Fouled away. The next 3-2. And another foul ball. Looking to set down the side on strikes. Here it comes. Still looking for our first hit in the ballgame. And he struck him out. So he was forced to make 9 pitches that at bat, but he'll take it as the inning is over. So now into the box is Brian Goodwin. 7-8-9, bottom of the order, set to go here in the third. The 1-1 home is swung on and missed for strike number 2.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Brian Goodwin goes down for the first out here in inning number 3. Not trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Popped up. And there's the second out as he squeezes it in the coach's box. Next to hit will be the pitcher, Lance Lynn. This guy's still looking at a 0 in the hit column. The 1-1 is a slider taken for a ball.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. But sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Here now the 2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Digging in, the switch hitter, Ian Happ, as we move on to the bottom of inning number 3. Happ with a 2-1 count now. Looked like that one tied him up a bit, a swing and a miss.
Man, this has been a game filled of a lot of swings and misses. Not very many confident swings, and this team up there, they'd swing at a butterfly right now if it threw in front of the plate. Lots of swings, lots of misses, a lot of ugly at-bats for this team right now.
Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1. And he misses again, ball 3.
You know, when you haven't gotten a guy on base yet in the entire game, a 3-ball count kind of feels like a little mini rally. Let's see if he can get on.
Now a sinker this time, but this ball stays outside as he loses him here. It's ball 4. The 1-1 pitch. And they'll try and play for 1 here as he gets this one down. To second for 1. Throw back to Abreu. They get them both, and the side is retired. Next to bat will be Tim Anderson as we begin the top of the 4th.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
To the left side, but it's well foul. Here's the 1-2 delivery. And this is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third, with a strikeout, and there's one away. Both teams so far yet to crack the hit column. Two balls and a strike to Cesar Hernandez.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
3-1 to him now. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Chopper to short. Knee high, he barehands it. It's in time. So there are two gone now in the White Sox fourth. And one of the more prolific RBI men in the league the last few years, Jose Abreu, will bat next. And it's fouled away. The 1-2. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. 2-2. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Back to the top of the order now, and up next, Nico Hoerner. The 2-1 home will not catch the zone, ball three.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
And that's out number one. Now stepping in next, number 62. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. The 1-1. Waves and misses for strike number two. Cubs to this point have yet to break into the hit column. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away. Next, here is Matt Duffy. He's 0-for-1 thus far. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Yeah, that looked like a strike, but let me tell you, when you're staring at a big zero in the hit column, getting a call like that to go your way can feel like a big victory.
And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Stepping in once again is Yoan Moncada, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Swing and a miss, strike two.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
Struck him out, and he becomes the ninth strikeout victim thus far. Now to the plate, Gavin Sheets, trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. Hit on the ground to third. Over to first, and that retires the side. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and set to go is the third baseman, Patrick Wisdom. 3-2 pitch. Right side, hit hard. And that's the first hit in this one for the Cubbies.
The batter, number 18.
Into the box now, number 18. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Next to hit will be Wilson Contreras. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. One and two now as that one's fouled off.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Their count now at 2-2. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count, you send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Another payoff pitch. Got him. And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame. And now Ian Happ looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. The 1-1 home. Runner goes for second. Strike called. Now the throw down. And he'll be tagged out at second base. Trying to get into scoring position, but instead the inning is over. Next batter to the plate, Brian Goodwin. One and two as the changeup had him out in front there.
Classic case of the front shoulder flying open on that off speed. Needs to stay compact and stay in the big part of the field.
Looking for his 10th strikeout. Here's the pitch. And a half swing that time, but it's a full swing in the eyes of the umpire, and that'll be the first out of the inning.
Now batting.
Striding in is Zach Collins. Popped into foul ground his last time up.
Yeah, Matty, and I think that pop out was just a result of poor pitch selection. Got to see the pitch over the heart of the plate. He chased well out of the zone, and as a result, didn't really put a good swing on that.
The pitcher, number 33.
Into the box, Lance Lynn. And they'll try to stay out of the double play here as he lays this one down. One there, but wisely no thought of a return throw, and the inning will continue. So it's a runner at first with two men out, and up next it'll be Tim Anderson. And a pretty good take there on the slider down. It's ball three.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
And that'll get down out there near the wall. And a relay to the plate. And not in time as the run scores. So now to the plate, Cesar Hernandez. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. Takes that one a little bit low. 3 balls and a strike now.
Well, that backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's a very effective pitch. If you can hit the outside corner with that pitch, it's unhittable.
And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out. The set and the 2-1 swing, and he puts a charge into this one high and deep, and you can't forget about it. This ball is gone. Kyle Ryan, the 6'5" left-hander, takes over on the mound now. Standing in now, Yoan Moncada. Now here's a shot out to right center field. He's through first and hustling for second. And he is in the second with a two-out double. In now, Eloy Jimenez. Hit out towards second. He's got it. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring up the former first rounder and Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. And he fouls this one off. Chopped weakly to the left. Here's another 2-2. And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
Now that one.
Next up is Jason Hayward. Worked a walk his first time up. And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. Counts even to Hayward, 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Hey, it's tough when your team is being held scoreless on the scoreboard. He was trying to put him on the board with a swing like that one.
Here now the 2-2. And he struck him out. The 10th victim sat down on strikes thus far. Ian Miller will pinch hit here with 2 outs and the bases empty. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Fouled away.
Wow, that's 4 straight K's. He's knocking him down. He's looking for number 5 right.
Got him looking, and that'll do it. The inning is over. Trevor McGill is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Trevor McGill.
New inning set to get underway, and next it'll be the outfielder, Gavin Sheets. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. On the run, this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Not much he could do with that one. Tied him up at knots.
Good plate discipline to lay off the slider that time, and he draws even a 2-2.
The classic back foot slider right there with 2 strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
Stepping up is now Brian Goodwin. 0-2 for him to this point. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself at a good hitter's count.
And it's fouled away. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Lifted down the line in left. Left fielder is on the move. He can't get there as it falls in.
Up next to Chicago, the catcher, Zach.
At the plate, Zach Collins. Hit back up the middle. Scooped up. There's one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Now back to the leadoff spot in the Cubs lineup. Stepping forward, Nico Hoerner. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. Popped him up. Moncada in foul ground. One down. Now into the box. Number 62. It's been an 0-2 effort for him to this point. Pitch on the way. There's a good breaking ball as it gets the bottom of the zone.
You could tell this guy's got great feel for all his stuff right now. To break out that nasty hammer right there, this guy's on point.
He's just rolling right now, and even dozen strikeouts for him in the ballgame. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate.
Boy, he's been great in this one. He's only 1 strike away from putting another 0 on the scoreboard.
2 balls and 2 strikes to Duffy. Now a flare out toward right center. And that will conclude matters here in the 7th. Now to the plate, the pitcher, Lance Lynn. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. The 1-1 home. And, oh, he can't get out of the way of that one. So the leadoff man will be on to open the frame. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Tim Anderson. He doubled his last time up.
Yeah, give me a repeat performance of that last double. With a man on first right now, let him run, get you a ribby.
Full count, 3-2. Swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning. At the plate now, Cesar Hernandez. Tough to do much with that one. A swing and a miss. Lofted in the air out toward right center. On the move is Hayward. Makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And the run will score on the sacrifice fly, so it's now a 5-0 game. Digging in will be Jose Abreu. A potential second run of the inning stands at third.
That last at bat, Matty B, a changeup right down the middle of the plate. Listen, this guy's got a great changeup, but he can't afford to keep throwing it middle like he did that last at bat. If he does, this guy might be hitting back-to-back jacks.
Throw will be to first for the second out, but meanwhile, another run is in to score.
Up next for the White Sox.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Yoan Moncada. He doubled his last time through.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
Now a slider well off the plate, an easy take there.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
The 3-2 one more time. Line drive to center field. Happ finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Patrick Wisdom. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. Fastball laid off well below the knees.
Well, he's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
Number 18. No runs, just one hit. No errors so far for the Cubbies. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. Ryan Tepera enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. Wilson Contreras will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. A strike to Contreras and it's 1-1. And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now 1-2. Hit on the ground to third. Hernandez at second. On to first. And talk about doing the job out of the bullpen. One batter, two outs, and the inning is over. All set to start the ninth in this one. And up next, the exciting Eloy Jimenez. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. On the move is Hayward, but he won't get to it, and this should put a man in scoring position to start the inning. Around second now and headed for third. And he's going to make it safely. And a great start to the ninth as it's a leadoff triple. Jason Adam enters now in a mop-up role as he'll try to keep the deficit right where it is. Stepping in now, Gavin Sheets fouled off. Two-two, here it is. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. Next, it'll be Brian Goodwin, singled in his last at-bat. Ready to deal, here's the 1-1. And he makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Brian Goodwin goes down for out number two in the top of the ninth. The 1-1. And there's strike three. So we'll see now if they can manage to hold on to this huge lead as the side is retired. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And that'll bring up the former first rounder and Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. And he fouls this one off. The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Now at the plate here is Jason Hayward. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat. Fouled away. One out, nobody on. And he struck him out as well. So the bottom of the order providing little resistance here, and there are two away.
Number 66.
The Cubs are down to their final strike here. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Hey, it's hard to win games at any point, but to win games on the road, especially in this ballpark, so they are very happy with this win.
6-0, the final shutout score today. The Chicago White Sox rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Lance Lynn gets the W on the mound. Adbert Alzale struck out 10 in the losing effort. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious White Sox, 6 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 3 men on.